Welcome to Fairtrade Finder. In today's video, we are looking at the Bluetti AC180 versus the Anker C1000 portable power stations. Before we get started, if you find this video helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more reviews and comparisons. Let's get started. Starting with capacity. So this is one of the most important features of a power station. This is how much energy it can store before it needs to be recharged. Think of it like a fuel tank in a car. The bigger the tank, the farther you can drive before you need to refill. Capacity in a power station is measured in watt hours. The higher the watt hours, the more energy the power station can store. So the Bluetti AC180 has a slightly higher storage capacity at 1,152 watt hours compared to the Anker's 1,056 watt hours. However, the Anker capacity can be expanded by adding a battery pack. Next, moving on to output. How powerful is the battery? Output is how much electricity the power station can deliver to your devices, like whatever you're plugging in, your phone, laptop, other gadgets. If a power station has a high output, it can power bigger devices. If it has a lower output, it might only be able to handle smaller gadgets or a few devices at the same time. Output is measured in watts. Continuous output is the amount of power that the portable power station can provide consistently over a long period. Surge output is a temporary burst of extra power that it can provide for short periods, typically just a few minutes. So when we look at the output of these two power stations, they have equal output. However, where they differ is that the Bluetti has higher surge power than the Anker C1000. Next, moving on to battery type. So this is the type of lithium ion battery that is running the power station. Both of these have lithium iron phosphate batteries. This is really good because this gives you more longevity, charge cycles, safety, less chance of your devices getting overheated or overcharged. Next, let's look at charge cycles. So this gives you an idea of how long your battery will last. A charge cycle is one complete round of using a portable power station's battery from full to empty, and then recharging it back to full. In simple terms, every time you fully use up the battery and then recharge it, that counts as one charge cycle. Over time, as you go through more charge cycles, the battery's ability to hold a charge starts to slowly decrease. Bluetti has more charge cycles than the Anker C1000. This Bluetti gives you 3,500 and the Anker gives you 3,000. So, that could end up being an extra few years of use out of the power station. 3,000 charge cycles, if you maintain the power station well, you store it correctly, you keep it charged, you could easily get about 10 years of use out of a power station like this. Next, outlets and ports. What can you actually plug into the power station? So the Bluetti AC180 has 11 outlets and ports, and these consist of AC outlets, USB-A, USB-C, a DC car port where you can plug the power station into the cigarette port on your car, and a wireless charging pad, so you could just lay your phone on top of it. In comparison, the Anker C1000 gives you the same number of outlets and ports. However, where they differ is it gives you more AC outlets. You get two extra AC outlets. I find this really useful because these are your most standard types of outlets that pretty much anything can be plugged into. You also get an additional USB-C ports, so they have an equal distribution of USB-A and USB-C. And you get your standard car port. You don't get a wireless charging pad. Now let's look at how long it takes to approximately recharge the power stations by the different modes that you're given. So AC recharging is the most standard. That's where you just plug the power station into a wall outlet to recharge the battery. The Bluetti recharges in anywhere from 1.3 to 1.8 hours. The Anker C1000 has an ultra fast charging mode and can recharge in about an hour. Next, let's look at solar. This is how fast it takes to recharge the power station with solar panels. The Bluetti has a slightly lower solar input level than the Anker. So it would recharge in about 3.3 hours with 500 watts of solar input. Now this is an estimate. A lot of this depends on, the quality of sunlight that you're getting, how you position the power station. So this could take longer. It depends on your setup. The Anker C1000 has recharges by solar in half the time because you get 600 watts of solar input So it would recharge in about 1.8 hours. And again, this is all dependent on your solar setup. So it could be longer, just depending on the situation. Bluetti gives you an additional way to charge the power station, which is by plugging into a gas generator. The Anker doesn't give you this option. This should take about the same amount of time that AC charging takes, anywhere from 1.5 to 2 hours. So this lets you know how easy is it to carry the power station around. The Bluetti AC180 is heavier at 37 pounds, or about 17 kilograms, whereas the Anker C1000 is 28 pounds, or about 13 kilograms. I'm just rounding. Next, connectivities. They both have Wi-Fi capabilities, so you can plug into your internet connection and control the power stations using, you know, native apps that they give you. Where they differ is that the Anker also gives you Bluetooth. And Bluetooth comes in handy when you don't have internet connection. So in terms of price, they have the same retail price of about $999. I didn't input the sale price for the Bluetti, but the Bluetti is on sale on Amazon for about $449. And the Anker C1000 is on sale also at Amazon for $549. Now, if you want to expand your Anker, that's going to cost you about an extra $949 per expansion battery. And that's where you have to decide, maybe it is better just to buy another power station if it's going to cost you as much as the original power station. They both give you the same 5-year warranty coverage. Sometimes power station brands only give you like 24 months. Now let's look at what they have in common. They both have lithium iron phosphate batteries. They both give you a baseline of 1800 watts of output. You get 11 outlets and ports, app control, Wi-Fi capability, and you have the same 5-year warranty. Now, in terms of how they're different, let's look at the pros and cons. With the Anker, you have expandable capacity, faster overall charging by AC, solar, and DC, which is plugging into your car's cigarette port. You get more AC outlets, and it's a bit more lightweight. On the negative side is you have lower surge and less charge cycles, so a bit of a shorter lifespan. For the Bluetti, you have higher surge power and you have more charge cycles. The negatives are the capacity isn't expandable. It takes a bit longer to charge across all the different modes. It's heavier and you don't have any Bluetooth. So if you don't have internet connection, you wouldn't be able to monitor the power station using the app. So I hope this helps in understanding the differences between Bluetti and Anker. Please let me know in the comments if you have any feedback or experience with these power stations. I'd love to hear about it. And thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon with more comparison videos.